Welcome to this broadcast. It's my pleasure to share the word of God with you, my people of God. As we share the word of God from the book of Lamentation, as I begin to read from chapter 3, verse 24. The Lord is my portion,
as I come to see,
seeth my soul. Therefore will I hope in him. The Lord is good unto them that wait for him, to the soul that seeketh him.
Mercy said no.
The Lord is good unto them that wait for him. It is good to wait for the Lord. For he says, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not weary, walk and not faint. So it is very good to wait on the Lord. To the soul that seeketh him, it is good that a man should both hope and quietly wait for the salvation of the Lord. The Bible says, trust in the Lord and lean not on your own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge him. He shall direct thy path. It's a good thing.
So hard to see.
That a man should both hope and quietly wait for the salvation of the Lord. Sometimes you might be saying, you want to change. When is this breakthrough going to take place? When is this turnaround gonna happen? But it's good to quietly hope in the Lord and wait patiently. At the end of the day, it shall come to pass. The burden will be removed from your shoulder, the yoke from off your neck. Every yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. It is good for man to hope quietly with patience upon the Lord. It is a good thing to wait. When you wait on the Lord, he will renew your strength. It is good for a man that he bears the yoke in his youth. It is good. For a man to bear the yoke in his youth, it is good to go through diverse hard times, troubles, go through wilderness situations in your youth. Bear the yoke. When that yoke is broken, come off your neck. You will be celebrating throughout the rest of your year. The Lord will pull you from the back.
Thank you, Jesus.
And bring you forward. He sitteth alone and keepeth silent, because he has borne it upon him. Seems like sometimes the Lord sits back and watch you go through a whole lot of troubles. But it shall come to pass when that burden will be removed from off your neck. He putteth his mouth in the dust. If so be there may be hope. He giveth his cheek to him that smiteth him. He filled him with reproach. For the Lord will not cast off forever. The Lord will never leave you, will never forsake you. The situation might look rough. Hold on. The Lord is with you. He will never leave you, will never forsake you. He will make your way out. The Lord bring water in wilderness places and cause streams out of dry places and make the rivers a dry land. He brings forth water out of the rock. He rained down manna for the children of Israel. He split the Red Sea into two for the children of Israel to pass through. He fought for you. He will never leave you, never forsake you. You will never be put to shame. But though it caused grief, yet will he have compassion according to the multitude of his mercy. That caused grief. The Lord will have compassion according to the multitude of his mercy. He will cause compassion. He will. It's a compassionate God. For he has doth not afflict willingly, but give the children of men to crush under his feet all the prisoners of the earth. The Lord will never leave you, will never forsake you. He will never forget your labor. Your labor of love will not be vain. Sometimes you wonder why you go through certain situations. Where is God? He's there watching your back. He will never leave you, he will never forsake you. The Lord is sure it will be right on time. It is never too late. He will make a way where there seems to be a way. He will restore all those wasted years. Take you from the back of the land and bring you forward. So hold on and trust in the Lord. I know you have been blessed with this few exhortations. I'm Sue Jackson. Stay blessed.